drunk. Left Scarlet and Gray all day. Did a man somebody talking about they really wanna stand around? 6'4", did it get short? Did it make the mama talk about she wanna get down? You're presidential, you are residential. Why you look at me like you really want that one? If you know what I know, or if you do what I know, you be looking like, bro, it's time for you to go. It's the bobbity, boobity, boobity, bobbity, ziggity, zing, ziggity, zow. Zuzus and wormers and wormers and zuzus and people be looking like he's putting down. The fire that I really admire. When I listen to the 46 or the 640, your honor, I'm a bomb like Sarah Connor. Do you even know what I am saying? There is a reason they call me Desperado, cause I am about to go super sad. I said, I'm a bomb like Sarah Connor. Do you even know what I am saying? There is a reason they call me Desperado, cause I am about to go super sad. The 640, now I'm on my way, man.
What more can I say?
What more can I say, man?
Now I'm on my way.
Now I'm on my way, man. Now I'm on my way, man. The 640.
Turn me down. What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Y'all know what this is. It's 640. Hey, hi, everybody. You miss me? You miss me? DJ 640. I'm in the building. Me and my girl right here, Missionary Antoinette.
Praise the Lord, everybody. God bless each and every one of you. It's good to be in the house.
Yes, it is. Wow, man, it seems like I've been away for a couple of weeks and everything, but I see you and 320 has definitely been holding everything down for me. So proud of you, and I'm definitely so proud of what you did at the church the other day. I saw it on everything.
Oh, you
everything.
Saw my video?
You did, yes, absolutely.
God be the glory. Thank you.
Did a wonderful job. I told you guys, didn't I? I said, Missionary Antoinette, just pump them brakes just a little bit. You're going to be going. But you did. You're a natural at it. I'm serious. I'm really, really, really proud of you with that.
So what he's talking about for all our listeners, I had the opportunity to come and speak at Faith Temple Number 2 for the Bible school, and it was phenomenal. We had eight other guests besides me, and I was the last, and the Holy Spirit just took over. I mean, I fasted, I prayed, as I do every day, but it was really phenomenal. You can check it out on my Facebook page at Antoinette Webster.
Cool. And absolutely kudos going out to 320 as well. I understand he's been holding it down really well too. So
He has a beautiful guest. Okay. I mean, a beautiful co-host. She's lovely. She's very, very, very lovely.
Yes, indeed. And also, just a couple of things I want to let everybody know about Cinco de Mayo that we're going to be at Chevy's for all the local folks here that's listening. We're going to be over at Greenbelt this Friday doing Cinco de Mayo, the 6:40 evening show over there, and I'm real, real excited about that. We did that a couple of years ago. We didn't do it last year, but we did it year before last, and it was really, really good, so I'm real excited about that. And also, moving fast forward a little bit, for the mothers and stuff out there, you know, Mother's Day is approaching. The 6:40 evening show locally again. We'll be at the Outback.
Praise God. Yeah, that's a hot thing right there, the Outback.
Yeah, right. So
whoever see me, give me some crunchy coconut shrimp.
Yes, indeed. So, yeah, I want to big shout, early shout out, early Mother's Day to all the mothers out there, you know, and we will be actually keeping you up abreast with that, what's going on with that.
Amen.
As that time approach.
Amen.
Wow, and I see you have a guest today.
Yes, I do. Before I get started with my guest, first, I just want to say, first, give honor to God, who's ahead of my life, and to each and every one of our listeners out there. I want to give a special shout-out to my number one loyal listener, Robin Bland Lewis. And, you know, we have a couple other normal loyal listeners. Mr. Paul Taylor, you know, he's watching. And, you know, to God be the glory for all those that do tune in. We are truly, truly grateful. We just want to give you guys kudos because you all have really, really been great in following us from where we came from. And we just want to say thank you. Yes, I have a guest today, and his name is Mr. Carl Marbley.
And we're going to get right to Mr. Carl Marbley in a minute, but like we do each and every Monday right this time, we're going to get to your guest, Ms. Harrison. Now, you know I don't mean to cut you
Take
off, but
time.
You know I
Take
love doing this part, but we want to...
That's it.
We got to let Sweet 16 bring us into the hard drive. Sweet 16, take us to the hard drive and take us there, baby girl.
Hi, this is Destiny. You're now in tune to the 640 Evening Show featuring my daddy, DJ 640. Hey!
We'll be right back.
Whoa. Yes, yes. We back, ladies and gentlemen. You know, I gotta get a little rusty with that Sweet 16 introduction. You know, it's been a couple of weeks and everything, but we gonna kind of adjust that a little bit so I can get that in all the way. I don't hate when I be cutting off Missionary Ashton. I know she'd be ready to get into her thing, but you know what? What I wanted to say on the top is that I've been reading up and listening. A lot of stuff on the news been hitting me about these kids. It's the epidemic with heroin uses that's going on in a metropolitan area and stuff, and I think it's been hitting even further than that. And I was just like, wow. I was just thinking about that. You know, the kids are really into that. Do they know what that? Don't they go to the movies? Didn't they see what was happening out there in the '70s and stuff with that stuff, man? And it is coming back. It's amazing how things just absolutely don't. Only thing that just the faces change. The names and the faces change, but the things just stay the same. You know, I thought we moved on from that, and you know, and everybody had better education and knowledge about that thing, and we just let it go.
Medicine chest.
Yeah, I'm just like crazy. Then I saw on the news today that they went into their supply of dog care medicine, and they using that to
Are
get
you
themselves.
Serious?
Yeah. Yeah, I was like, what is that all
That's
about?
Crazy.
Anything to get that extra boost.
That is crazy.
I'm good with the wine tasting that we have here. Big shout out to E-Life Media. We have a little wine tasting up here. If anybody in the area you want to come up here to Capitol Heights up here to at the with the strip mall and just come down here, you know, just a big shout out to the fellas up here that's doing the wine tasting. With that, Missionary Anthony, I'm going to go ahead and turn over there to you and with you let you introduce your guest today.
Praise the Lord. First, give honor to God who's ahead of my life. Before I do anything, you know, I always start out with prayer. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord, we just want to say thank you. We thank you, Father God, for life, health, and strength. We thank you, Father God, for giving us activity of our limbs and being in our right frame of mind. But Father God, right now, we turn over everything that we have to say out of our mouth. We turn over every idea, every thought, and ask you to touch us from the top of our head to the sole of our feet. And let this interview be in you, Father God, that you take total control of everything we want to think, say, and do. Have your way in our life. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Wow.
Praise the Lord. I'm so excited. I'm truly, truly, truly excited.
Feel like I'm doing communion with this wine.
You know what? 6:40.
I mean, it just hit me. I was like, wow, I'm doing communion.
He is silly. He is so silly.
Oh,
I'm so excited just to have the guest that I have today. As you all know, that's not new to tuning into me. My topic is in truth and in spirit, and the scripture comes out of John. It says, I am the way, the truth, and the light. No man cometh to the Father except through me. What that means, you got to get it right while you have time. You have time. When he wake you up every morning, you still got time to get it right. Don't let no devil in hell take you away from God. If you've walked away from him, still come back to him. Because why? You can't get to him unless you go through Jesus. Call on the name of Jesus. Because at the name of Jesus, demons must tremble. At the name of Jesus, every knee must bow. And every tongue must confess that Jesus is Lord. Don't let me start preaching here. I do have a guest. I want to give him his time, but I want to set some things straight in the atmosphere and let you know that you're not by yourself. I don't care what it look like or what you're going through. You are not by yourself. If you are breathing and you're watching me and you can hear my voice, God loves you. If you're under and you ain't seeing enough and your heart ain't beating, oh, we'll see you when I get there. But to God be the glory, we have to know now, and we have to serve notice to the enemy to let him know that you can't have my family. You can't have my family. You can't have my friends. You can't have nobody I know and I don't know. So I come to tear the kingdom down, shake the devil up, make him move out, plead the blood of Jesus over everybody that I know and I don't know, because I've had both sides of the world. I've had the side of the world that I thought I was having fun and I didn't have fun. But now I got the best side of the world, and that's in Christ. So without further ado, you know I always introduce my guests with a scripture.
Yes.
And with that being said, is the scripture that's given to me. For what the man does, for what he does in his life, I think that the best scripture for him, from what God is telling me, is this one right here. I just have to get it. And I always wait till the last minute, because that's when God speaks and gives it to me. But to God be the glory. I'm very, very excited. I thank all my listeners. And I'm asking in the name of Jesus that y'all keep my brother in prayer, because he's not feeling well in his body. And even, you know, even the fact that his wife has been sick. So keep Kenyatta in prayer. And just know that it could have been you. You know, so don't say, oh, I'm not going to pray for somebody, but I'm needing my prayer warriors to put on their whole armor of God and keep it on and keep praying for each other, and we're going to do the same for you. The scripture that I'll be coming out of is John 15. It says, I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman. Every branch in me that beareth not fruit, he taketh away. And every branch that beareth fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit. Now ye are clean through the word which I have spoken unto you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branches cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine. No more can ye expect, except ye abide in me. He says, I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me, and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, ye can do nothing. If a man abide not of me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered, and men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. If ye abide in me, and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word. And the reason why I introduce you all and present to some, Mr. Carl Marbley.
Good afternoon. My name is Carl Marbley. I really appreciate the introduction I was given by Antoinette Webster, but I would like to add a little bit to that. For in my life, I've dedicated my whole being towards helping young people get their acts together and move forward. I am a teacher, I've been a mentor, I've been a foster parent of 76 children, which the majority of them graduated with honors from the PG County school system, and I give up myself to the community because I've done pretty well throughout my life. I've been blessed, and I make it a point to bless people around me.
Amen. So, Mr. Carl is a little nervous, everybody, but we're going to plead the blood of Jesus.
Take your time, Mr. Carl.
That Mr. Carl do what God wants him to do. So, with that being said, I met you through the school where you work at with my daughter, and I just want to give you thanks right now while I can. I've always, you know, told you thank you, but I believe in the times of her struggle that if it had not had you in her life as far as her teacher, her mentor, then it would have been a lot harder for her. So I just want to say thank you for all that you do, and if you can just elaborate on being in truth and in spirit, if you can just tell the people just how good God been to you, just how him using you. That's what that scripture means, because I can't pick the scripture. He picks them for me. But when he had me pick the scripture, it's because I know that you love God. I know that you listen to God. And I know that if it had not been for God on your side, then you wouldn't have made it to have all them other little branches. You know, to have all them other little children, to speak into their life, to mentor them, to raise them, to be who they are now in a productive world of society.
Okay, right now I'm a retired teacher from the PG County school system, but after about 4 or 5 years, I became a little bored, I missed the kids, and I went back to kind of help the young men learn how to own their behavior so that they can stay in school. Sometimes an apology goes a long way. A lot of these kids, because they're fighting on their own to survive with parents working, both mother and father, a lot of times they don't have time to spend time with them. And then you got the single mothers, which Ms. Webster spoke about. My hat's off to each and every one of you, but every mother may not necessarily be a mama, and sometimes we men have to step up to the plate. Now, I've taken on the role myself to reach out and help kids all throughout my community just to get their education. I've gotten the majority of them to go to college and get full degrees, and most of the kids that lived in my house, like I said, it was a total of 76, which included my two, most of them make between $50,000 and $200,000 a year. It's a gift given to me by the Heavenly Father, and I pass it on. And that's how I live my life each and every day.
So with that being said, what is your greatest accomplishment that you what would you say is your greatest accomplishment, your greatest strengths as working with the kids now?
My greatest strength is being able to get through angry kids. I've run into a whole lot of them. I've met a lot of them. And I have not met one kid that I haven't been able to get through and help him to calm himself down and have a man-sized conversation. And what I try to get them to do is realize that at a certain age, you're about to become a young man. And I talk to the young girls at school too about respect. If you allow the fellas to talk all types of conversations to you, you're not going to get the respect. So right. I try to get them to respect yourselves first. You have to love God and then love you first.
Come on now.
And once you love God, you've given all the love you've got to God, God's going to give it back to you, and he'll help you to disseminate the love to everybody else. But it takes you loving God and then loving you before you can properly pass on the love to somebody else and then be meaningful.
That is so awesome. I heard you speak about your daughter. Is anyone in your family going to... Well, tell your family that they can also catch you on YouTube after this segment.
I will tell them.
But I know that I've had numerous conversations with you, and I understand that you also have a testimony as well.
Well, several. No, like I said, I gave myself to God when I became a single parent. Unfortunately, my marriage did not work out. And my kids were about to be cast in a situation where they would be going into foster care. So I made up my mind to rise to the occasion.
Amen.
And I said, she didn't bring them here by herself. And I'm a parent as well. So I said, well, I have to slow myself down. And like in your life, everything wasn't good for me. But I had to settle me down, get back into church, get my head on straight so that I could do what I needed to do for my children.
Right.
I'm happy to say that both of my children make 6 figures per year.
Cool.
I don't have to worry about them. They don't have to worry about me. When in a time when many parents are looking at their young adult children and they have to take them back in and take care of them and so forth and help to hold them up, I haven't had to do that, thank God.
That's
and I don't need to lean on them because I'm a very independent person. And like I said, I'm true to what I do.
Mm-hmm.
My kids constantly tell me, Dad, you give all the love away and you don't get anything back. I said, my love comes from the Heavenly Father.
Absolutely.
And I'm quite pleased and satisfied with what I have. I have lived my life with a positive mental attitude. I have love for myself, too, even to the point when I go to doctors, I tell them, you don't love me like I love me. I have faith in my Heavenly Father, and I have faith in you to run your report. And once you run your report and we look at the things where I'm having problems, then it's up to me to determine whether or not I'm going to take medications or whether I'm going to do, go nature's way. And I've been healthy all my life. I'm not a pill taker. I discourage people from taking pills. I can endure pain until I can get through it and keep moving forward. But I am not infected with all the drugs that are coming out, with all the chemicals, to the point where as I have to take another drug to correct this one and another drug to correct that one, I don't have to worry about any of that.
So, Mr. Call, in your time of being at PG County School, what is the worst scenario that you've seen for the kids, and what way were you able to speak into their life of someone that you've seen really, really going through?
Well, there are many kids that, and me going back to Duval High School, I actually go in and on my own as a long-term substitute, I select a certain number of seniors, and I make contact with their parents, and I tell them whenever they have a problem, have the administrators talk to me. We'll ground your kid, get the heads back on their shoulders, and keep them in the classroom. I'm trying to stop, a lot of parents end up losing their jobs because of problems that the kids have at the school, and they have to constantly take off. So with me being the mediator, the administrators come to me, I have an agreement with the parents, and then we can keep them moving forward, because when I sit down and I talk to them, the first thing I tell them, have I done anything to you? I've done nothing to you. Mm-hmm. Why do you think I'm here? Why do you think they sent you to talk to me?
Right.
And I make them understand I'm here to try to help you to stay in school. I don't want to see anything negative happen to you. I don't want to see you lose your opportunity to get your education. But some of the behaviors in today's times, and I think a lot of it is due to our technology and everything.
Exactly.
The
I agree.
Kids are, oh my God, they're going overboard. And like I said, in an extended effort on my part, just to get them to graduate, I will work with parents with their kids in the high school until they walk across the stage.
Cool.
I will stick with them every step of the way. Even if I decide not to stay at that school and I go to another school, I go right back and I stick with those kids all the way up until they graduate.
Hey, Mr. Carl, let me ask you a question, because that's ironic that you had brought that up, and what I brought up in our introduction to the show. Have you ever ran across any of that, what I had touched upon, any of it, like as far as like the substance abuse or anything like that, with the heroin, anything like that? Have you come across that with any of the
fact,
kids?
In foster care, you're going to run into a little bit of everything, but I have certain rules in my house, and I told them, you have to live by my rules. I'm going to try and help you to get you to a point where you can stand firmly on your own feet, And as your life, as you progress in your life with whatever credentials you build for yourself, then I advise the kids to go back. You reach back and you help your parents. You cannot control what happened to them in their lives.
Amen.
Only thing you can do is ground yourself, move forward, and then reach back. And maybe we as children can teach our parents how to live a better and stronger life.
Oh.
So I encourage them. And all the foster kids that I've worked with, I've accomplished that mission in getting them to rebuild the relationship with their parents, because I try to make them understand you need your parents. Your parents need you. And I said, man, whether or not you're on the same plane or not, maybe you can reach out and lift them up a little bit by your progress.
Mm-hmm.
But you have to make progress in order for the circle to become the full cycle. But
that's
true. I encourage them every day at school. I encourage them every day, get your work done. If I go into a class and I substitute, I generally get 100% turn-in of the work. I am very, very demanding in that regard because I want to see them go forward. And I constantly tell them, I'm not on your case because I dislike you. I don't want you to fail on my watch.
Amen.
So let's get your work done. Do I need to call your parents? They don't want me to call parents, but I get the work turned in, and they are, Duval High School is very satisfied with the work that I do for them because
I extend myself.
Mr. Cole, I'm just trying to say, that's good. But did you answer my question?
I thought I did.
Don't listen to him. He's messing with you.
You were talking about the drugs that are on the market.
Right, yeah. Did you ever come across any situation like the stuff that's going on now? Did you have challenge had come across your plate with one of the kids or anything like?
No, cause
like
I was so rigid.
Okay, good.
My household, they didn't dare bring it there.
Not in your house, but with the kids that you had.
Well, within the community, I've seen it all over the place, and it's unbelievable.
How could it make a bounce? How could it make a return like that, Andy?
You know? Well, you know, it does. It starts from peer pressure. It starts from being hurt. When I got turned into drugs, mine started with me wanting to fit in. So you have now in the world, you have different technology, you have different phones, different everything. Everything is like out on the market. So you have
everything
these kids that don't have, that want to have, and they figure they can fit in to get in wherever they can. So now you have the saggy pants. You got the drugs. And believe it or not, you probably have some kids that's in there in the school without a shadow of a doubt that their parents are on heroin, that are on crack. You can basically look at a child and
tell
what's going on in their home. You can tell by their body scent. You can tell by the way they dress. You can tell by their neglect of their schoolwork. You can tell by their malnutritionist. Exactly.
Classroom.
You know. So with that being said, you know, I give kudos to Mr. Call because I've been knowing him now 4 years, and he does just what he say. When he say he gonna call you, he call you.
I get on the phone and
he will actually call you when he see me. He always has a report for me for my daughter, even when she wasn't in his class, and that's what I love about him. And we have a certificate. I didn't bring it for you from eLife Media for being who you are, for what you do at Duval High School, because I wanted to recognize you for you being a great mentor in the community.
Yeah.
And I did not bring it, but I will bring you back on the show to present it to you,
okay,
if that be the case, or present it to you tomorrow night, Tuesday night at the Seniors Award, you know, because we need to recognize who we have in our community and who we have in our classrooms. And with that being said, 640, there are some people, and believe it or not, see, the community now is not that intense on having people take drug tests. They have a drug test for you to get in the job. Once you get the job, you ain't got to pee no more. So a lot of students are doing what they want to do.
Absolutely.
But if we had more Mr. Calls around, it wouldn't happen. We've had people get fired from that school. We have people that did everything, you know, XYZ, and they're no longer there. But if we had more men and more women that were in tune with their students' lives and accepted the students as their children and not as somebody they're supposed to bogart and threaten all day long, because you ain't going to have an education if I don't teach you to. Devil is a lie.
That's true.
You know, and with the love that I watch him daily. For the love that he shows the kids, the students at the PG County schools, is phenomenal.
Well, let me tell you one other thing. They made a new ruling last year in light of some of the problems we've had in the county in the last couple of years that you can't embrace the kids. When I go down the hall now, the kids, when they see me come in the building, Mr. Mobley, they want to hug me, and I tell them, well, I can't hug you back. I stand up just like this because you'll
you can draw a charge from that. And I think it's it's such a terrible thing because, you know, a lot of kids need for you to just reach out and touch them.
Right.
But I do understand why they made the decision, because there are too many people out there that are taking advantage of our children and abusing them and pulling them down the drain. And it's a shame. It's really sad.
I've seen it.
I've seen that happen. But as far as the drugs that you were talking about early, I can go back and say I did experience it in my life with my youngest sister. She was the closest family member I had, and it was almost as if she was my daughter. I protected her. I looked out for her. But once she got out into the community, the peer pressure was overwhelming. And she was actually forced to take drugs, and she could never get herself together. So she made it a point, by the time she turned 35, she couldn't take the pressure anymore, and she chose to end her life.
Oh, man. So sorry.
That was the sad part. And I miss her every day. She's been dead now for about 15 years.
Wow.
I ended up raising her daughter. Her daughter is 36. No, it's been more than 15 years. Her daughter was 10 at the time. So for the last 26 years, I played parent to her daughter. She was my daughter, too, along with my two children.
You know, I see blessings all over your life. I can see how God has truly blessed you for taking care of his children. Because the word of God says, who is my mother? Who is my father? Those that do the will of the Lord.
Absolutely.
And I just thank you so much for taking care of those that couldn't take care of themselves.
Your daughter came up to me the other day when I asked her, do you have everything straight for graduation? She told me, yes, I have everything. I told her, give me a hug. I said, I am so proud that you made it across this finish
Amen.
Line. Because we're in a tough environment.
Yeah, and we are. And with that being said, you know, about my daughter having an IEP and things of that nature, what I love about you is that you never look at no kid different.
I don't. I really don't.
He never. I mean, we have one total classroom that's, they have development disabilities, and everybody is treated the same from him.
Everybody,
you know, and that is so phenomenal. That makes a big, big difference in their lives. Because you really may not know, but that award is truly, truly, and I wish I would remember to bring it, because you probably would have been crying on the show. But that award is long overdue for you. Because to God be the glory for what God has placed in your life for you to do such a challenge as that. And for you not to give up, even after you had already ran the course and got retired, you said, no, I got to go back and get some more.
I got to go back and work
because
with these
I'm
kids.
So thankful. I am so grateful.
I'm looking at them go down the drain. Now, for the longest time in Prince George's County, when a lot of the kids ended up going to court, every summer I was subpoenaed to court, I'd say roughly about 12 times, to stand in behalf of the kids.
Wow.
Okay, now many times when the kids were put on probation, the master that was in place at the time would allow me to be the probation officer. I wasn't a probation officer, but I made the kids understand. Do not play with me. I'm not as difficult as a probation officer, and I will call you 48 hours before I come, and I expect you to be there. Don't make me come and have the police come with me. I have never had a problem. So I feel that there's more that I can do. I'm trying to reach out and do more. I'm trying to set up a facility in PG County, because kids that are emancipated from the Department of Social Services, they're cut loose generally at the age of 18, and they have nothing
they
to turn to.
In the
so
streets.
I'm trying to rally people together to put together a program for extra care for emancipated kids in foster care. Because once they're out there trying to sell drugs, they're breaking into people's houses and so forth, because they don't have another support system that they can turn to. So I'm trying to put that in place here in Prince George's County. So I met with some people, and we got some good ideas. I'm going to meet with Steve Harvey to get information from him on how to set the program up, and I may even go through his training program.
Praise God.
But I want to put that here in Prince George's County. So.
Praise God.
Okay.
Wow, that is so phenomenal. We are so excited for what God is doing and everything that's going on. You know, to God be the glory. I can't begin to say nothing else but to God be the glory, because it's so phenomenal. I really wish I had this award for him. But, you know, we can't change that because I don't have it. But and my segment is almost over. If you have any information that you'd like to give to the people, you know, any for any child that may be listening, because we'll be on YouTube, for anyone that want to reach out to you, can you tell them your information? If you're on Twitter, if you, whatever, any way that you want them to reach out to you, you can speak and look into that camera right there and let them know that they can always call on you if they're serious. And even if they're not serious, a way for them to learn to get serious. Please, 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 please don't turn the TV off before he says what he has to say. Get this information in. Go ahead, Mr. Marvin.
Okay, I am based at Duval High School, and I leave myself open to any kid in Prince George's County simply because a lot of them are out there actually suffering, and they have no one that they can call and even talk to. I had a program while I was working at Parkdale High School. I gave the whole school my telephone number. I told them, I would rather you give me a call and let me give you some options before you make a decision based on tunnel vision, and then you end up in jail. Right. I'd rather help you to think your way through it before you get yourself in trouble. I do a lot of that at Duval right now. I have the kids come and sit down and talk to me. I don't have a thing about me that will hurt you in any way, shape, or form. I want to see you rise up. I want to see you own your behavior, and I want you to realize that your education is a monumental piece for you, and you have to accomplish that in your life. That's the one thing you have to accomplish as a child, is to get your education. Then once you get your education, you turn 18 years old, the same laws that apply to me will apply to you.
Right.
But at least you'll have a base to get started and move forward. You can't do anything much out here now in terms of employment without at least a high school diploma.
Right. So would you like to put your information out there for somebody to get in touch with you?
Okay. My name is Carl Marbley. My website is cmarbley, Marbley, @49@gmail.com. You can email me at any time. I'm going to even extend my telephone number, 240-435-8884.
Okay, so Mr. Marvin, I heard you say PG County kids, county only. I hear a child in D.C. may need some help. Can they call you?
Well, I worked between D.C. and Prince George's County Department of Social Services.
Okay.
I had kids in my house from both before they made a law that you cannot have kids from different states. So the ones that I had,
I understand why you said that. Okay.
So I'm dedicated to where I live, and I'm looking at the kids here suffer.
That's fine. I understand that. I just wanted to, you know, clear that part up. So to God be the glory. With that being said, this is your girl, Missionary Anshinette, coming to you live from eLife Media, the ultimate media outlet, broadcasting live radio and TV worldwide, powered by live music for you. Before I close, we'd like to hold hands. I'm going to say a prayer. And I thank Mr. Carl Marby for coming on. And Father God, in the precious name of Jesus, Lord, we just want to say thank you for the show. We thank you for the segment. Continue, Father God, to lift Mr. Carl Marbley up. Father God, continue to touch him from the top of his head to the sole of his feet. Continue, Father God, to wrap your arms around him. Continue, Father God, to use him for your glory, for the purpose that you have him here, Father God. Touch each and every child's life that he comes into, Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Father God, bless 640. Bless 320. Bless me. Bless my brother, man. Touch him right now in the name of Jesus. Bless his wife, Father God. Bless Deion Lawson. Bless everybody that tuned in on the 640 Evening Show, the New Horizon platform for independent artists. Father God, we continue to give you glory, honor, and praise for what you're going to do in our life. God, I thank you. You know everything I have on my prayer list for me, Father, for you, from me, Father God, and I ask you to bless it in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father God, I can't do nothing without you, but I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. And we turn over everything to you. And for that, we're so ever grateful. And we just want to continue to say thank you for your love. Thank you for loving on us. Thank you, Father God, for all that you do. In Jesus' name we pray. And our souls should say amen.
Amen.
Amen. To God be the glory. It is so awesome, 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 awesome guest, 640. Awesome guest.
Absolutely.
Awesome
guest. Thank you, Mr. Carl, for coming in. We appreciate that. We appreciate you. Definitely got to get you in here again. Absolutely.
Okay, I forgot to tell you, they had a big write-up on me in the Washington Post a few years back. And then they highlighted me in an article in New Carrollton, and they sent it all over the state. So.
Oh, praise God. Cool. Woohoo! We got to get that clap machine in here.
Yes, I do a lot of things around this county, and I love
what
I do.
That's a blessing. Praise God. Praise God. Well, I will be bringing you your award. If we can get you back in here as soon as possible.
Okay.
If you
want
to be presented with it on TV, that's fine too.
I'll be better prepared.
You were prepared just now as well.
I'm so nervous right now.
It's okay. God bless each and every one of you out there. Shout out to my number one lawyer. Listen, Robin Bland Lewis. Hey, baby, how you doing? God bless each and every one of you. Shout out to each and every one of our family and friends. We love you dearly. And for everyone that doesn't have a church home, please feel free to come over to 607 62nd Avenue, Mount Calvary Free Will Baptist Church, with Dr. Melcy Brown is my pastor, and we have service every Sunday, starting at 10 o'clock for Sunday schools, 11 o'clock for the Sunday morning worship, and on every Wednesday, we have it starting at 6:30 for the prayer, Bible study, slash meeting, and we just, testimony, we're just going to have a phenomenal time. I'm excited, 6:40, I'm happy to see your face in the place.
Yes, I am.
Miss you last week.
Eat Life Media. Yes, it is. Eat Life Media. And we'll definitely be back. Actually, let's go ahead. Let's go right here to the music break right quick. And we will definitely be back. And it's the 640 Evening Show. Eat Life Media, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all keep it locked here. Let's take me away up here.
I got a condo in Manhattan. Baby girl, what's happening? You and your ass invited. So go on and get to clapping. Go pop a phone, pop it for me. Turn around and drop it for a plan. Drop it for me. I'll rent a beach house in Miami. Wake up with no jammies. Lobster tail for dinner. Julio served that scampi. You got it if you want it. Got it if you want it. Said you got it if you want it. Take my wallet if you want it now. Jump in the Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want.
Just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby. You deserve it all. Lucky for you, that's what I like, that's what I like. Sex by the fire at night, silk sheets and diamonds all white. Lucky for you, that's what I like, that's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like, that's what I like. I'm talking trips to Puerto Rico, say the word and we go. You can be my flica, girl, I'll be a flico, mamacita. A promise that I can't keep. I promise that your smile ain't gonna never leave. Shopping sprees in Paris, everything 24 carats. Take a look in that mirror. Now tell me who's the fairest. Is it you?
Is it you?
Is it me?
Is it me?
Say it's us.
Say it's us.
And I'll agree, baby. Jump in the Cadillac.
Girl, let's put some miles on it.
Anything you want.
Just to put a smile on it.
You deserve it, baby. You deserve it all. Lucky for you, that's what I like, that's what I like. Sex by the fire at night, silk sheets and diamonds all white. Lucky for you, that's what I like, that's what I like. Lucky for you, that's what I like, that's what I like. You say you want a good time, but here I am, baby, here I am.
I think I like you. saw your smile from way across the room. We were strangers. I was bashful too.
We were dancing from across the floor.
Tell me what's your name. Love your style and your swag's insane. Come on over, tell me what you like. Gwendolyn, wanna take a bite.
Come ahead, wanna look you over.
Real tight, gotta get you closer. Ooh, you smell nice like I knew you would. Here's my number and my name. Damn, you look good.
I saw your eyes smiling back at me. We were lovers.
We were lovers.
In our fantasy, we were smiling. Across the floor.
You're now in tune to the hottest internet radio show east side of the Potomac, the 640 Evening Show.
What's happening, man? You know what I'm saying? This N.O. right here, New Orleans, man. I want y'all to peep out, man, my man 640, man, for the evening show, man. He doing it like that, man. He all over, you know what I'm saying? Shout out, man. DMV.
What up, what up, what up? We back up in here. What's up, Big T? Look at the cat that drove in here again.
Baby. How you doing? What's going on?
What's up with you?
Well, you know, baseball is almost finished, brother.
Yeah, baseball almost finished. The NFL draft.
NFL draft is going on tonight.
It must be some sports up here.
You know what's going on. Yeah. Get ready to happen, right?
Yeah.
What's getting ready to happen is the Washington Redskins are about to blow it again. So I'm going to tell you that right now. Hey, if you're listening to me, and I know you have internet going on right now, Redskin Park. Don't pick who you think you're going to pick. Pick who you're supposed to pick. Daggone it. Hey, Dan, wake up.
They can't mess up at 17, can they?
Hey, man, they done already messed up. they can't make it right if they had one.
You know,
I'm going to be like that. I'm going to tell you, until y'all fix it, that's how it's going down.
And you know, I can't be misunderstood. I gotta ask you about what's going on with the Wizards, man. Why they didn't close things out in Atlanta and they had to come up here? Why they keep dragging this thing out?
You know
they're gonna make me go seven games.
It ain't going seven. It's over with tomorrow.
You think so?
I would guarantee it's over with tomorrow. Or it's over with.
Is Bill going? I mean, what is he going to show? Are we gonna get the Bill that we got yesterday at least?
Everybody, calm down, relax. They gonna win this one, but. What's going to really happen is, who are they playing next?
Boston?
Maybe. Chicago? Possibly. Neither one of those teams can handle the Wizards.
Defensively,
they're not equipped to handle them.
Uh-huh.
It's too many odd pieces with the Wizards right now. They don't fit in terms of a matchup. So what you have to really understand is that when you're trying to match up with the Wizards, you're really putting yourself at a deficit for defending them. Now you're taking away from look at how the big man for Atlanta is doing right now, man. He's about to lose his lunch.
Which one?
Because I'm talking about how.
Okay.
Because he can't score and rebound.
Like I said, to scratch my hair, I was like, sometimes I don't even see him on the court.
He's there. Yeah. He disappears.
Right.
He's the invisible man.
Yeah.
It's 4-on-5. Really, he there, and he'll come out here and block a shot. But that's not how it's going down.
And let me ask you a question, T. With that though, why sometimes even like to an extent yesterday he was having a pretty good game last night, but you know, why do they take him out? Why are they monitoring his minutes so much?
Because he ain't really doing nothing.
If he ain't doing nothing but just protecting the rim, he's doing something.
They lost.
Yeah, they did.
So he ain't do it. you have to understand, you know, Howard is a particular type of ball player, man. Yeah. He needs a particular type of group of guys around him to perform. He can't do it by himself. Look at Chicago. They done fell apart because Rondo hurt. It ain't got nothing to do with the fact they got over, the old boy got over his sister's death, which is not really something that I make it a point of saying. These are professional athletes. They turn it on and off. They have switches.
Yeah.
Okay? They have switches when they have switches when they go to the playoffs. They have switches when they start the season, the preseason, their off season. Everything's a switch for these guys. Okay? Everything's a trigger. So, you know, that didn't do anything but motivate the Boston Celtics to play. But if you have a wounded animal and you're a hunter, you're not going to give a kill shot?
Yeah.
So that's their fault.
Right.
That's their fault for what they're doing. But when Rondo went down, it made it times 10 the problems that are going on. In terms of, first of all, we know about what happened with Rondo when he was complaining about why they were complaining about him and all this. Let the guys play, man. Sometimes you have people in the league. Nobody say anything. They try to control Dennis Rodman.
Yeah.
They try to control Rick Mahorn. They try to control a lot of different types of guys, depending on what they do, how they do it. They couldn't control the two that I just mentioned. So how are you going to control this guy? You can't.
You can't.
So he's a grown man. He's richer than anybody on the bench. Okay? He's richer than all of them. Trust me. Because he's made all the money. All right? He is the quintessential point guard with height, size, and vision, and understanding of the offense that he runs, and understanding of how offense is supposed to be ran. So when they finally buried the hatchet, you got Butler, you got Wade, you got Rondo, and everybody's happy.
I didn't realize how much he meant to them until they went to the series, you know, with Boston, man. Because, you know, Rondo was like, okay, they got Wade and Rondo, but since he got hurt, it's like, you know, it's night and day with them now.
What did Paul Pierce say about Rondo about 5 to 7 years ago?
Yeah, tell me.
The ultimate point guard that makes it run.
Oh, okay.
Rondo could coach the team. Literally. And he's probably going to be a great coach because he has that attitude of,
it's my way. Sticking his foot out, tripping people up.
I do the same thing. Well, I'm trying to win. Sorry. That's how it goes down. Yeah, you all right. You make $1 million. You got insurance. Buy a boot. Nobody said nothing to me. I'm just joking. I'm sorry. But that's what he was thinking. No, but, you know, he came up with the story. I always stretch my leg out. I'm like, man, go ahead, man. That's like Reggie Miller saying, you know, I always stretch my leg out after I shoot. No, you kick people after you shoot.
Hey, Big T. I know you was while you were sitting over at the green room. I know you was back there listening, man. Yeah. What this thing that's really been getting serious, man, with this this heroin epidemic that's going on with these kids, man. So, you know, I know you've been hearing a lot of stuff about it. If you have, man, can you
elaborate on it?
Yeah, what's
it? Ain't never go nowhere.
It ain't never go nowhere.
Let's stop playing games. All right. We have drug tests for every situation possible. If you're arrested, no matter what, when you're arrested, you're administered a drug test. Plain and simple. What they did not test for was marijuana. They test for every other substance.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you go to court and they say, hey, you have this, that, and the third in your system, they're really not testing for marijuana. But they do test for opiates, such as cocaine, heroin, and it's never gone anywhere. Kids have been sniffing heroin in little corners of the country for 150 million years, man. These opiates are not going anywhere. It's nothing. They might go out of style.
Okay.
Like e-pills went out of style, right?
Right.
They haven't gone anywhere. It's just like when the NFL, when the Super Bowl champions, win their Super Bowl and they give them all these t-shirts and hats, you think that they didn't have some other t-shirts for the losers? So what do? They can't put it in this country, so they send it to another country.
Oh, they send it to another country.
So you looking around at the, let's see, who was in the Super Bowl last year? The New England Patriots and who?
Let me see. Probably Atlanta.
See, probably, because can't nobody remember. Now, probably Atlanta's worked. All their paperwork and all their hats and everything are somewhere else.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's funny how people think, oh, man, I thought they kicked this. No, they never kick it. It's never kicked,
so basically,
ever.
So basically, it's just never reported. And when they found it conveniently to report it and to put it out there, that's when they...
Well, let me ask you a question. When they said they're going to change the taste of Twinkies, who stopped buying the Twinkies? When they said, we're going to change the taste...
Yeah, I remember that. I remember that.
Yeah, we're going to change the taste and take all these saturated fats out.
Right.
How many people still go to McDonald's?
Yeah, they still go there.
They still go there. Right. They adapted their mentality of how the food tasted. The same thing with drugs. These kids are adapting their mentality. They're being shown by somebody what it is.
Music.
Whether it be a parent that does not know or whether it be an individual who wants to turn them on to it.
Right. Now,
I never got into cocaine. I never got into heroin. I never got into pills. I never did all that. I never really got into a lot of alcohol.
Right.
You know, I don't have a problem with it. I have a moderate effect of everything. But when I see cocaine users, I know them. When I see heroin users, I definitely know who they are and what they do.
Right.
I can tell you what's going to happen.
They fool.
We've been together sometimes. Like, watch them just tip over.
Right. It fooled me, man. Because I'm like, you know, I'm just basically, you know, looking, going through my notes and stuff. And I, you know, go through the wires and stuff like that. And I look up and I say, heroin epidemic,
man,
and kids are dying of overdoses at an alarming rate. I was like, where have I been?
Let me tell you something. Back in 1995, when I came back to D.C., I saw kids sniffing. I was like, what, they sniffing cocaine? What's wrong with them? Nah, man, they sniffing boy. What? They've been in this neighborhood forever, and they know what it does to the people.
Right.
It's not about that. It's not about that at all. Sometimes, you know, people are tricked into it. Sometimes people are led into it. And sometimes people are just guided that way. And that's just the way they're going to be because of what they've seen. They don't know anything different.
I think, man, let me know if I'm wrong about this. And, you know, it's cool if we disagree about that. But I think they be tricking their kids and our youth and stuff into it in the music and the stuff that they see and what they see.
Yeah, I agree
with
that. I agree with that.
And I think instead of calling it one name, they'll call it something named that sounds sweet or easy on the ears or popular.
Right.
What makes them want to go out and do it. Okay, because this rapper does it, this person does it, and they're turned up.
Oh, yeah.
Having such a good time.
Yeah.
Let's go here. Let's do the same
thing. All of a sudden, 10 years later, you ain't turned up no more. You ain't got no buttons.
Exactly.
You know, it's... I deal with kids from the ages of 10 to 18 on a regular basis every day.
Mm-hmm.
I deal with adults who have addiction or might have had an addiction in the evening time.
Okay.
Night and day. When the sun rises, it's a new day. When the sun sets, the day is over. It's the same thing. I wish I would enough. I wish I could have. I should have done this and I should have done that. No. Just go ahead and do what you're going to do. Now, if it's negative, then you're going to get a negative situation brought back on you 9 times out of 10. Unless, you know, you fall under the category of babies and fools. You know?
True.
But after a while, God can't save you. You have to save yourself because He gives you the opportunity to save you. He gives you all the tools you need to do what you need to do. Now, some of us are strong and some of us are not as strong. I won't use the word weak, because when you have an addiction, it's not like on TV. It's a mental thing. This is mental. This is something, I like the way this feels. I like the way this does this, that, and the third. So I'm going to continue to do it, not knowing that if you just read a little bit, you'll see that within about another 3 to 5 years that your body's getting ready to fall apart. Your mentality is getting ready to change. Next thing you know, once your mentality changes and your body falls apart, you start looking the part. Now, you want to walk the walk? Then something's got to give. Now, what do you want to do? Do you really want to walk the walk? Now, experimentation, I understand. I don't have you and I known each other forever. I don't have any peer pressure problems. I'm too mean for peer pressure.
True.
I'm mean as a mug for peer pressure. You want to make me do something now? Just you trying to make me do it or trying to make me feel like that's gonna make me mad anyway. Okay, that's just my mentality. Don't tell me what to do like that. But as we get older, that mentality softens, and you start understanding why they're pushing you. Because misery loves company. It brings you in, it draws you in, and it locks the door behind you. As soon as you step in full throttle, boom, and you can't get out. So my advice is, don't let the door slam you with a good little split you. Stay up, pay attention, especially to the youth out here. Pay attention to the negative connotation. Believe in what's going on. You don't have to always speak on it. You can always say, you know, let me see what this is going to bring. Let me see how this is going to go down. Let me see. Oh, I don't like that. Well, if you don't like it, then walk out the door. If you don't like it, if something makes you afraid, you get away from it.
Yeah.
But my advice is this. Don't just get away from it. Read about it so that you won't put yourself in that position again. Gotcha. Understand where you are.
Gotcha. Other than that, man, what's been going on with you, man, and what you bringing to us today? I know you got some things that's going on with you. How was the baseball team? How was y'all season?
We doing fine right now. Looks like, you know, first of all, you know, I got the 8th grade team and I got the JV team over at St. Albans, so we're doing exceptionally well. We just beat Landon today. Both teams won. 4-3 win by the 8th grade team, a 4-2 win by the JV team, and we're moving towards participating in the IAC title.
Last we talked about that, I was in Florida doing it like that.
We did a pretty good job of we had a new team. It was a new team. We had to come together, but once we got back from Florida and they played that competition, it was over and done with. Okay. I'd like to give a shout out to the folks down at Avon Park in Florida.
Okay.
The folks over at the Benjamin School in West Palm Beach that we went to. We were in Tampa Bay. We were in Okeechobee, which is Central Florida, South Central Florida. It's not the Everglades, ladies and gentlemen, and it ain't Disney World. This is I ain't talking bad about your Okeechobee. I'm just saying it's not a one-room town, but when you ride through, you riding through.
Yeah,
it's the highway goes through Okeechobee.
Right.
So, but it's some of the best youth high school and minor league baseball in the entire world.
Good talent out there.
These people are just as good. They even know about some of the talent that we have up here at St. Albans, mm-hmm. Georgetown Prep, okay. DeMatha High School, Catholic High School. And I want to give a big shout out to Riverdale Baptist.
Okay.
They have some of the best baseball in the country. And they've allowed us to come out there and play with them. So, you know, there's things to be part of. There's things to be part of. And I want to just let people know that a lot of stuff is happening. But you have to open yourself into it.
Okay.
If you open yourself into it, you won't have that problem.
All
right. So, but Bulldogs is doing fine. We're doing all right.
That's what's up, man. So, you know, T, man, so it's cool, man. I love it, man, the way we can just pick back up and everything, like when I get you up in here, man. So, we got to make this thing a reoccurrence, man.
I'm almost ready, man. I'm letting everybody know
we're getting the team back together.
I'm almost ready, man. I got some things that are, you know, working out right now. I'm trying to get some other stuff doing, you know. But that's why I say, hey, man, what you doing today, man? Well, come on to the show. Well, all right. Yeah, I'll be there.
For sure.
Hello,
for sure,
man. How you doing?
For sure.
Hey, what's going on with you in terms of stuff, man? What's happening, man? What are we doing here?
Well, you know, I've been they had me pretty much on lockdown for the last past 6 months. So,
lockdown? 6 months? You was locked up, man? What? They locked you up 6:40?
Yeah.
They locked you up? You see Bubba? You see Bubba?
I was hibernating for the winter.
Did you see Bubba? Bubba said, hey. You ain't see Bubba?
No, I ain't see Bubba.
Good. Because if you saw Bubba, we all got problems.
Yeah.
You know, because Bubba, you know, we talk about that all day. But anyway.
Yeah, didn't see Bubba.
No, but we are, you know, I'm also participating in the Delta's Cooking with the Gents.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's going to be happening May 6th.
Okay.
And I will be cooking. I'll be cooking the dishes. I'll be participating as a.
That's right around birthday time,
yeah,
huh?
You gotta come and get. I'm doing a dish. I ain't gonna say what I'm doing right now. I don't need you coming back and take it out because you know you like come on the back door. Be like, give me a plate. Give me a plate.
Right.
Nah, man. Ain't give me no plate. Because this is going to be a situation where we're doing it. It's a competition.
Okay.
And it's for scholarship. Okay. So it's very important that we all sort of support what people are putting forth. And let's try to make this a little bit bigger for our community. We don't have to make it for the whole world. Just make it for your community.
How can I be a part of it?
Okay, well, you can show up. You can buy a ticket. Ha! There you go right there. You got tickets. I'm going to have information for you. I'll send you some information so you can talk about it.
Okay.
And we'll put it on the website or something like that right now, because I don't have everything with me. I didn't bring everything with me. I came straight from the field, so.
Okay.
But no, we are, everything's looking pretty decent. I think we have about 50 to 60 cooks.
Okay. Wow.
Yeah, so that's going to be something special. I don't have everything. You got to pull it up on the Delta site real quick, because I don't have every. I apologize, ladies and gentlemen. I did not come prepared. Because he called me late. It's his fault. But no, it's going to be a great situation. I think it's going to be held at Trinity College.
Trinity, okay.
It's going to be at Trinity College on May 6th at 5 p.m.
Okay.
Delta's cooking with the gents. And I wish I could have brought the president of Washington, D.C. Alumni chapter in here again.
But it ain't too late. She
I don't know if she's going to make it.
I mean, you know, before then.
I'm looking at my skin watch. I don't know.
We got a couple more shows. We got a couple more shows before then, and she can come up there, give a few plugs.
What I'll do is I'll give her a call and see if we can bring her in next week.
Okay.
Next Thursday, and see if we can get it right before the show starts. That would be a good promotion for it.
All right. Cool. So any shout-outs you want any other anybody?
Hey, man, shout-out to Addison, Bobby, Zakeel, Zayas. What y'all doing? Hey, Elijah, stay out of trouble. Shout-out to my mama. Hey, mama. She ain't listening, but she'll listen one day. Now, look, but I want to give a shout-out to the St. Albans School for Boys and how they've treated me so well. I really appreciate them. The parents, the student body. And if anybody wants to call in and ask any questions about anything, make sure you give us a call here at 240-455-5934, man. That's 240-455-5934. That's E-Life Media, man, in the 640 Evening Show, man. Do your thing.
Yes, it is. So y'all don't go nowhere. Y'all keep it here locked on the 640 Evening Show. I am DJ 640. Big T's up in the building, 320. Hello. And the 320 Experience is coming up in a few minutes. Y'all just keep it here. You know how we do. 640 Evening Show. E-Life Media.
Yeah.
Amazing. Oh, having you close to me. about y'all.